finally time to leave the airport and head into Copenhagen. I'm super excited to go visit everything. I tried to book a hostel, but I can't reserve it online with PayPal, and my MasterCard isn't working. Hasn't been working this entire trip, so I have to go there in person. There's only 3 beds in the hostel that I want, so fingers crossed I get there in time. And now I just have to go find a bus or metro into the city. So, see you guys there. She said she can't fly. And here we go. This is Copenhagen. Just walking outside of the metro and it's already super pretty. According to Google, it is the world's most bikeable city, which explains all the two-wheelers here. Unfortunately, first thing I need to do is go find a hostel, so I can't look around yet because I don't have a place to stay yet tonight. So I'm gonna go find one. Forgive me before she said goodbye. Go into darkness before I try. Is life worth living when you need to get by? Okay, and I found my hostel, CPH downtown. The currency here is crowns, DKK, and it is nothing close to the Canadian dollar, and it's really scary every time you try to go buy something. So my room costs 355 crowns. But 1 crown is only 0.2 Canadian dollars, so it wasn't that bad, I guess. It was still more than I wanted to pay. But I mean, considering that I did it last minute, it's not that bad. Anyway, I am headed out to go explore Denmark now, so who knows what I'll see. But I'll take you guys along for the ride. Water, find a new space. Time, I will know that deep inside we don't ever let go. I was the king, but not the king of anything. Call me Mr. Righteous, even if I always. This is the Royal Library. It was made in 1920, along with all these gardens. And then the 8-meter tall water structure right there was made in 1999. I don't think it's running right now because it's winter time, if you can't tell. Look, it looks like I'm vaping 24/7. It's ridiculous. My toes are freezing. Do you guys remember earlier when I said it was the most bikeable city according to Google? Their stairs have railings. You can bring your bike down smoothly without it bumping up and down. What the heck is that all about? That's nuts. Okay, so as you guys can see, I made it to the round tower. My grandfather suggested that I visit it. We have to pay to go to the top, and it's really foggy today, so I'm gonna wait until tomorrow. Hopefully it clears up. And then I'll go because I want to be able to see something aside from just clouds. So as you guys can see, it is tray foggy out and I'm freezing cold. So I'm going to head back to that library, work on a video, eat some food. I'm just going to quickly check to see if I can go in this building. It's like the old stock exchange apparently. So it might be pretty cool. I guess we'll find out. Okay, just kidding. That building is definitely privately owned and not open to the public. So can't go in there, so just back to the library. I sold my soul to the devil, said you don't need your heart. Okay, so it is a few hours later now, 3 to be exact. It's about 4:15 currently. I was working on that video for another 3 hours. I definitely worked on it for at least 3 hours yesterday too. The thing with when I travel is I only get to do it once. So I only get one first Copenhagen vlog and I only get one Barcelona vlog. So when I make them, I want to try to make them as good as I can because I only get to do it once. So that's why they take so long, which, and it's always like a double-edged sword. Like, do I spend more time vlogging or do I spend more time out capturing things? And I just never know how to balance it because I still want to do them daily. Anyway, it's pretty hard. So I don't really know what to do here this late at night and there's still a whole lot of fog. So I'm gonna go check out that little mermaid statue. I've never heard of it before. Apparently it's a big thing here though. Everyone's mentioned it. So hopefully it's cool. I don't know if it's super big or just like, maybe she's hot, who knows. So I'll see you guys there. Now I'm no expert or anything, but judging by the sheer lack of light, I feel like this is one of the things that you're supposed to do during the daytime, not during the nighttime. I was worried that the mermaid would be like in the middle of the lake and wouldn't be able to see it because of the fog, but now I'm worried that I won't be able to see it because there won't be a light. What have I done to myself? Maybe I'll just come back tomorrow. It was a little less exciting than I thought it was, but the statue is over 100 years old. It was made in 1913. It's like 175 kilograms and it's 1.25 meters tall. It's based on the story by Hans Christian Andersen, which was then made into that Walt Disney film, The Little Mermaid. According to the guy that was telling someone else this, it's been like spray painted a bunch of times and decapitated once or twice, and like a bunch of protests have happened here. So like whenever anyone's upset, they go and like deface a national statue, which is pretty lame. But yeah, that was a Little Mermaid statue. If you guys haven't been here or seen it before, you're not missing too much. I might come back in the morning to get a better look at it. But yeah, now I'm going to see if I can re-find those Christmas markets and maybe get some hot chocolate. Or honestly, I watched a video and they said that the hot dogs here were really famous and I've been smelling them every time I walk by a hot dog vendor. So maybe I'll get one of those too.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to laugh and sing a sleigh and sleigh.
Okay, so while I was FaceTiming with my grandfather, he told me about this lovely bridge where everyone locks their love away in these little padlocks. And then he said, but if you go to the right of it, there's this door, and that's where all the old dudes piss, and it's called the pissoir. So thanks for spoiling that nice little romantic bridge right beside the Christmas market, Helgi. Love ya.
Check out this lighting. I'm so lucky.
Anyways, I just got back to my hostel after the Christmas market. I'm gonna crash right now. I'm super exhausted. I have not slept a whole lot in the past 2 days. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's vlog. Today, I just kind of went everywhere and everywhere. I didn't have a plan. But tomorrow, because it's my last day, I'm definitely gonna have a plan and follow a direct route so that I know exactly what I'm doing. Unfortunately, it's supposed to rain, so that's not going to be too much fun, but hopefully my raincoat keeps me safe. Anyway, peace out, Cub Scouts. I'll see you in the next one.